This drawing's called the Blue Pelican. When you're in a big city, you find lots of different strip clubs and things like that for gentlemen to get their rocks off. You know, you've got Playboy, which used the bunny symbol, and Spearmint Rhino, which isn't as sexy as it thinks it sounds. I can't think of any other big ones, but the ones that are in Leeds all have animal names, like Blue Coyote or Coyote Ugly, like the film. You know, there's always like a bit of a sexy animal that comes to, I don't know, like be provocative within an establishment. I don't know. I don't get the link. I don't know why animals need to be in these titles, but they tend to more often than not have an animal. Well, the strip club in Bradford is called the Blue Pelican. So I don't know who thought that one up. Like, it's not only the least sexy bird, it's also one of the least sexy animals in general. You know, you've got worms that are a bit worse, or slugs, but a pelican with its big wobbly neck, and, you know, it's got no decorum. It just doesn't, in the slightest, hint at sexy. I mean, there's not even a nautical link. You know, Bradford is landlocked, and there's not a big fish market here or anything like that. We don't have a zoo. There's no reason why a pelican would be a good idea for a strip club name. I guess that the owner would probably argue that Spearmint Rhino has got nothing to do with the place it comes from, unless it comes from like a chewing gum factory in Africa or something. But, you know, that's become a franchise, and that's in many different cities across the globe, and it matters less about your name when you're that big. But Blue Pelican, so far as I'm aware, there is only one. And long may that stand, because I can't imagine it's very good. It's not even in Bradford town centre, really. It's like out of the centre just a little bit. You know, it's not like you'd get pissed and think, oh, we'll just go in here. You know, it's on the same strip. You'd have to go out of your way to get to it, and there's no other bars around it. And it's always got like a stripper stood outside trying to get you in, and a bouncer looking like he don't want you to come in, as though he owns this stripper, and it just doesn't look great. So yeah, I can't imagine it's going to be a franchise anytime soon. And if that's the case, you should change the name. I'd change it. I wouldn't have entertained the name in the first place, but with hindsight, I'd change the name. So that's my advice for any budding strip club entrepreneurs that might be on the rise. Think long and hard about your name, because it quickly becomes unsexy. Be wary of what animal you pick, because, you know, if you're picking the pelican or the, like, frog or the Gibraltar monkey, then people are not going to want to go